Is it really possible to achieve your dreams? Everyone grows up with dreams. Maybe it's to play in the MLB or the NFL or the NBA. Maybe it's to make millions or just make enough to be happy. Big or small, dreams are something that give people something to look forward to. In my case, I've had the same dream my whole life. Something a very small number of people have accomplished. In order to understand my dream, you have to understand my childhood. To understand how I spent every second of my life. I've given up a lot of things I wanted to chase my dreams. Since 1967, the Bohannans have been drag racing. From my grandpa, to my dad and my uncle, and then down to my sister and I. For as long as I can remember, it's all I've cared about. I go to school, I go to work, come home, and go to the garage until it's time for bed. I've been living for the weekend since I could walk. The older I get, the more I love the sport. Even though I love it, there are still bumps along the way. My grandpa, who started it all, died in 2008 with lung cancer. At first, I really didn't know what to think. I know it was especially hard for my dad, though. Only a handful of times had he gone racing without my grandpa. He taught my dad everything about race cars. Even though he was a grouchy old man, he fueled our love for the sport, and we missed him more every day. Somehow my dad held us together and we kept going. 2009 showed us we made a good decision as dad won the division championship. But, fast forwarding 6 years to 2014, it was time for me to join my dad in the big cars as I moved down my junior dragster. The year started great, but on May 3rd, 2014, I had a bad crash in Columbus, Ohio, totaling my uncle's 67th Camaro. Yes, I had to call my uncle and talk to him. I almost threw up when I saw his name on the caller ID. This is when I found out who my friends were and how much support I had from them and my family. After the crash, I told my dad I was done. Not because I was scared, but because I was costing my parents stress and money that I didn't want to put on them. My dad, however, told me not to quit. He said I had the talent to do whatever I wanted to with the sport and I needed to keep going. So the very next week, I climbed into my dad's car and made it to the finals of my class. If it wasn't for my dad telling me to get back in the car and all the other support I had, I would have given up totally on my dreams. Now I'm working harder than ever to achieve my dream of racing for a living, spending weeks of the time doing what I love, away from home. Dreams make people who they are. All the nights I spent sleeping on the counter in the garage were the million questions I asked my dad daily. Basically, the point I'm trying to get across is don't think just because you have life ahead of you that you have to give up on your dreams. If they mean enough to you, they can be your life. That's how I feel about drag racing. It's not just something I do, it's a way of life.
Cause this just ain't something we do, it's a way.